EA Sports. It's in the game.
Ultimate team.
Hello, everybody. Coach here, welcoming you to Madden Ultimate Team. It's the NFL on EA Sports. Up next, we've got what should be a great matchup between the Philadelphia Eagles and the Philadelphia Eagles.
Here's the former Auburn kicker, Daniel Carlson, to get this one started. And off we go from Lincoln Financial Field. Gets around him. And they'll have good starting field position as he's up just shy of the 40. The Eagles on first and 10. They're ready to roll.
Watch tight. Tight ends right. Watch tight. Tight ends right.
Here we go. 120.
What's that?
Now it's the all-purpose back. This is Darren Sproles. And the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop him behind the line. It'll be a loss of a yard, and that'll bring up a second and 11. Okay, there's a tone setter. First play from scrimmage, stuff him in the backfield.
You know what they were doing last night in the hotel room? Visualizing exactly that. That's what they were thinking about. Making that play, having leverage lower than the offensive lineman, getting into the offensive backfield, knocking someone down. Just what you said, setting the tone early for this game.
Jeez, you are fired up.
When I see a play like that, I can't help it.
Wentz now to throw, and that is incomplete.
I know coaches tell us all the time that having a powerful arm isn't the number one thing they look for in a quarterback, but when you're trying to throw inside routes and you need to put some heat on it, it helps to have the big gun. In this case, just a little bit too much.
And that one hits a little too close to the goal line, and it continues into the end zone for a touchback.
Easy.
Watch edge.
Ready. We're waiting.
Stepping up. He's going to keep it. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. Right off the bat, it's a first down to start the drive, 12 yards.
And that was a nice, strong run by the guy they call the field general.
Run! Run! Yes, sir!
From the 32 now, here's first and 10.
We're going to work.
Here's the first carry for Ezekiel Elliott. And he'll work this one up to about the 38.
Good job, good job.
It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it second and 4.
Here we go.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
Yeah, baby, that's what I'm talking about. All day.
On second down, Elliott. And an alley to run. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. A really nice pickup of 14 yards, and it moves the sticks. Couple of nice carries back-to-back here, establishing the ground game a bit.
Yeah, these aren't bare-bones runs now. I mean, they're getting substantial yardage, the kind of yards you're looking for, right? Let's go ahead and use a cliche. Stay ahead of the change, right? Five or more yards each time, that's what you're looking for in setting a tone and getting your offensive line going.
Good sign on the opening drive. Nigel Bradham brings him down. A give to Elliott. It's a room to run now. And he's going to get this inside the 30. 17 yards on the pickup there. The drive will continue. It's a first down. You were telling me this yesterday. This is exactly what they want to do on the opening drive, establish the ground game.
Yeah, remember our conversation. We were talking about what one of the GMs in the league has told me repeatedly. It's a big man's game. It's not necessarily size. He's talking about playing some big boy football. Line up, get leverage, knock people back, and establish the run early.
That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. Back live with Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. It's the Eagles with the ball here to begin quarter number two, but they face a second and long to start things out.
Ready, we're waiting.
Right over there. Yeah, yeah. Mike,
come on, get set. 12, 12.
Watch the screen.
21, 21.
Watch the screen.
Now they'll throw with Breeze. Over the middle, Sharp's got it complete. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. And they'll get 9 there as that sets him up better for third down.
Under.
Breeze looking to throw on third and 2. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
That's a good job there creating the contact to force the incompletion. And now since it's fourth down, that should set up a field goal situation.
And a nice sigh of relief defensively to be able to hold them to 3.
Here we go.
And no signs of the field goal unit. They're going for it on fourth down. They'll go for it. It's Breeze. And my goodness, this is incomplete. Boy, it looked like he had it and dropped it. And the Eagles defense able to hold. A chance to get some momentum here in the second quarter, getting their first trip into the red zone, but unable to get it across.
And if I'm the head coach, sure, you feel some disappointment, maybe a little bit of deflation there because you didn't get it in, but I'm going straight to rah-rah mode. All right, guys, we didn't get it this time. It's only the second quarter. We'll be back. Let's get it later on. I want to keep this team up. I don't want them to feel like they've let everyone down.
Positive.
Got to be positive in this situation. It's too early to think that you don't have a chance to win this game. But it appears that they read man defense and went to the out route. And what you have to do on that one is the receiver's got to make sure he works a defender towards the middle of the field to give himself space to cut to the outside.
Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Xavier Rhodes with a pick. And he'll score. Touchdown, Eagles.
Stay focused. Come on,
Well, partner, I do know this. If you're a defensive back, you have more chances to make a team now than ever because people are using five defensive back, six defensive back packages. Not exclusively, but way more than before. That was a nickel package there, and what a pickoff.
Why is that? Why are they using that more?
Because more people are throwing the ball on earlier downs than ever before. This has become a passing league, and because of that, more defensive backs on the field on most plays.
And this is going to be caught. It's good. And that extends their lead by two more. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. And out now come the Eagles. And this is a unit that, to be frank, doesn't look like they've woken up yet. I mean, a punt and a turnover on their first two drives.
And I think the game's starting to take shape a little bit now. And I'm going to take it to the basketball world. When you're having trouble scoring or moving the ball in basketball, what do? Get it to their best player, right? Find a matchup, create it, exploit it, and try and move the football.
Now the first play of the drive there is incomplete. Line of scrimmage, again the 25, second and 10.
Here we go. 120!
Once again here on second and 10. And he's got the veteran here, it's Mike Wallace. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. A first down for the Eagles, Wentz fighting the former Raven Wallace.
Thus far, it hasn't been a real fun half for them, but a play like that, that may get them off the schneid a little bit, get them loosened up and moving.
Kind of seems like they've been sleepwalking and still sitting on 0 points.
And it's not always making an adjustment. Sometimes it's just going back to what you know can work and finally getting it done.
12 more yards there and another first down. 2 minutes to go here in the first half. We'll come back to Philadelphia after this. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10.
Go. 180!
On first and 10, here's Wentz. And complete to Zach Ertz. And brought down, but able to get it to their 30-yard line. Another big gainer that time. This one goes for 19 yards.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. That's really good for the game of football. You're getting better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination, guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
This team is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. They came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. Calais Campbell on the stop. Nice job there defensively to clamp down because really they've been on their heels this drive.
Agreed, and they really needed that one for confidence, just to feel a little bit better. But I don't know if I would be daunted by them stopping me on one run. This drive has gone pretty well. I could come right back at them.
And now the Eagles going to signal for a timeout as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. And Elliott puts this one through. And they get on the board, trailing now 8-3. So they do get 3 points, but that's now three drives with only the 3 points, not a ratio that's going to win you many ball games.
Not at all, Brandon. And think about it this way. We all know payoff is the key, right? And wouldn't we love to have the concession on every T-shirt that's been printed in football that says finish on it? Because that's the mantra everywhere. Got to be able to finish drives, put points on the board.
David Johnson now gears up to help lead this offense back on the field. We're in the second quarter. They've got the lead. The lead, though, not so much because of the ground game, because of their air attack, Charles.
So what they're seeing so far is the possibility of things loosening up later in the ground game. Through the air first, maybe they have to start respecting that.
Eagle pressure, too much this time. Down he goes. Timmy Jernigan. Getting in there from his defensive tackle spot to snow him under for a loss of 4. 58, boys, 58. On play action, it's Breeze. trying for Brown, and it's intercepted.
Breeze picked off by his former teammate, Malcolm Jenkins.
And he returns it into enemy territory, down to the 45-yard line.
Well, that's a drive killer right there. Not a really confident throw either. This one was kind of up for grabs, and it's going to come down the hands of the wrong team.
Pac-Man. 180!
50, check my 50. Wild Bill, Wild Bill.
So after the INT, here's Wentz. And the reception made by Alshon Jeffrey. And he just falls short down at the 1 yard line. So it's first and goal and a great opportunity to get that lead back before the break. From the gun, it's Wentz. And that is caught, but the back judge right there to say incomplete. And that one will fall incomplete. Clock here now, just under 30 seconds to go in this first half.
Here we go.
They'll try to run with a jay. And the second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. Now the Eagles will use the second of their timeouts as the stoppage will come with 23 seconds to go till halftime.
120!
They'll try and run it now with Sproles. What a stand so far defensively, and now that's going to bring up a fourth and goal.
Now this feels like old school football because this has turned into a good old-fashioned goal line stand. So on offense, what do you do now? Do you decide to run it or throw it if you go for it on fourth down?
And the kick by Elliott is good. And a second field goal here gets him back within a couple at 8-6 now. So the 3 points here, they're still down, but they put somewhat of a dent into that lead going into the break.
Anything helps when you're trying to chip away at a lead, but they do know that they're going to need a little bit better effort in the second half.
And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. The time remaining in the half as they come up on first down. Try to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. He's going to wind up and air it out. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete. Randy Moss, the intended receiver. And now it's second down. From the 24, they'll go again on second and 10.
We're ready.
Breeze again here on second and 10. Oh, a battle for it here, and this will be caught. And with just 1 second remaining in the first half, they'll call the timeout.
Hey, easy.
Check.
Ready.
The final shot before half for Breeze. And incomplete on the deep ball. We now proceed to the start of the second half. So the Eagles with the lead, and they're going to get this football first as the third quarter gets underway. This is taken just shy of the 10 here. And he nearly broke that for more, but as it is, they'll start this drive at about the 37-yard line. Out come the Eagles now as he'll go on offense first here in the third quarter. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had ability to see what you've done. They're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace because you are looking for some separation in this ball game.
The adjustment to the adjustment.
Without a doubt. Show them one thing, hit them with something else.
Yeah, baby.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
Well, he got half of what he needed there, 2 yards, and it'll bring up a third and two more.
Another scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker, and what that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
That'll make it fourth down after a loss of one.
It's a tough one right there. He ran right into the teeth of the blitz as the linebacker was freed up in order to stuff that one for a loss. I think quarterbacks got to see that. Got to find a way to audible into something a little more advantageous.
Throwing now is Breeze. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. A gutsy call. Turns out to be a good one, though. First down on a pickup of 11.
We always hear about guys wanting to make plays that quiet a crowd. Shh. After that one.
Here in the third quarter, they were hoping to get the stop, get the football back. Not the case.
What a completion on a fourth down play.
And some good tackling there as he stopped up at about the 41.